Hello, I posted a video on solar eclipse on 2nd December in which I had mentioned about Kala Sarpa Yoga that was going to be formed on 5th of December 2021. Today I will be discussing about this particular yoga that is formed by the arrangement of planets in a particular way in the sky and how it's going to affect the world or the earth in general, and how it will affect our own country, India, in particular. So let us begin. Hello. As I always say, Vedic astrology or Jyotisha Shastra is very, very vast and deep. And I don't think any of us can claim mastery over it. I have been studying this science of Vedic astrology for the past 30 plus years. Believe me when I say this, more and more I explore, more and more I try to understand, I still can't help feeling that there is so much to learn and so much to understand and so much to, much more to understand, much more to explore. So that is the magic of this astrology. Once you get fascinated, it's my passion. I'm not a professional astrologer. It's my passion. I've been studying it. I've been sharing my knowledge. So today I will be talking about the much hyped or much talked about yoga, which is called as Kala Sarpa Yoga. There are so many yogas in Jyotisha. You know, there is a Dhana Yoga, Santana Yoga, Kalatra Yoga. Any lots of yogas are there depending on the combination of planets. And we give Faladesh. Okay. This is likely to happen, this is likely to happen that way. This all, again, when we say this, this is again a karmic account. It's not that somebody, like, you know, we are trying to make up some story and tell. That is why when general predictions are given based on the rashis and all that, that doesn't apply to each and everyone. So whatever you read in the magazines or online or whatever, it may not be applicable to you because each individual's planetary combinations are different and his destiny is different. That's how the science of Jyotisha works. Well, today let us try to understand what is this Kala Sarpa Yoga. One of such yogas, most discussed yoga, is Kala Sarpa Yoga. See, Vedic astrology, if we talk, I mean, you know, if we talk about Varaha Miracharya, what he has written, or Parashar has written, all these Maharshi Parashar, all of them, they are focusing on seven planets. Okay. Now, what are those seven planets? Sun and Moon. In my previous videos, I have told you, Sun is a star, Moon is a satellite, but still in astrology, we call them as planets. Okay. So, Sun, Moon, Mars, then Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, and Saturn. Now, what are these Rahu and Ketu then? Rahu and Ketu are actually called as North Node and South Node, or these are called as shadow planets in astrology. But they are very, very significant. Those who have seen my earlier videos about planetary conjunction and all, which I posted last year, or, you know, Rahu and Ketu, these are the two axes. This is a legendary serpent. Again, don't think that snake and serpent are the same. Serpent is something imaginary, legendary. Not imaginary, it's legendary. Snakes are the, inhabitants on this earth. They are the animals. So this is this serpent. This was a demon serpent who went to for that Amrit Manthan and who came to know about they are being cheated, or he got a doubt that they won't get Amrit, and his head was severed by Vishnu's Sudarshan Chakra. Everyone, of course, almost everybody in India knows about this story. And that's how Rahu Ketu were born. Rahu is the head of the dragon, not dragon, that's, I mean, legendary snake. And this is the tail. Ketu is the tail. So Rahu is the head and Ketu is the body. That much you keep in mind. Now, when all the seven planets are arranged on one side of the axis, either on this side or on this side. See, I'll explain it to you when I show you the chart. I'll be showing you the chart also. Now, this Rahu and Ketu are always directly opposite to each other. That is about 180 degrees away from each other. All right. Now, what is this yoga? It's not just one. There are 12 different types of yogas that are formed, Kala Sarpa Yoga. So I'll just tell you the names. If I start explaining, this depends on the position of the Rahu and Ketu. Okay, then we call that yoga with a particular name. A video will become very long if I start explaining how each one is formed and all that. Maybe I'll post something else. If anybody is interested, please comment in the section. So there are different kinds of Kalasarpa yogas. Like, for example, Ananta Kalasarpa Yoga, Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga, Vasuki Kalasarpa Yoga, then Shankapala Kalasarpa Yoga, Padma Kalasarpa Yoga, then Mahapadma Kalasarpa Yoga, then Karkotaka Kalasarpa Yoga, then there is something called Shankachuda Kalasarpa Yoga, and then Ghataka Kalasarpa Yoga, and then Vishadhara Kalasarpa Yoga, then Sheshanaga Kalasarpa Yoga. So these are all different kinds of Kalasarpa Yogas we are having. But right now, what the world is going through, that is called as Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga. I will be talking about it in detail. Okay. Now, actually, last time in my earlier video of solar eclipse, I also mentioned that Mars is going to move the next day. That is on the 5th December. He was supposed to move into the Scorpio sign. So 5th December to 12th April 2022, till Rahu and Ketu change their axis, this Kalasarpa Yoga is going to be there. Okay. This yoga actually keeps on happening. It's a natural phenomenon. It's not that only now it is happening, so we have to discuss and talk about it a lot. It's not like that. It's always happening. Like, sometimes the planets align themselves like that. Then why few Kalasarpa Yogas are discussed so much? This again, you will have to connect the dots about the solar eclipse that happened just now. So, how many planets were involved, in which house they were involved, and how they are going to affect. And this Kalasarpa Yoga is immediately followed by this solar eclipse so that it becomes significant. So, any eclipse has got its ill effects or good effects, whatever it has to bring to the world, till the next solar eclipse. It means I had told you the date around the 30th of April. 2022, the effects are going to be there. Now, just little before only, 12th April, Rahu and Ketu are changing the axis so that Kalasarpa Yoga also will be cleared. It means the next 6 month period, like till April 30th, we need to be extremely careful. That's the thing what we need to understand. Now, actually, what we are having, the results get amplified because of this solar eclipse. What I meant to say is that. Now, actually, again, there are two terms, Apasavya Kalasarpa Yoga, Savya Kalasarpa Yoga. I don't want to confuse the listeners too much, but you should know the terms. Apasavya Kalasarpa Dosha is when seven planets are moving away from the tail of Ketu and entering towards the head of Rahu. Okay, the other one is vice versa. Actually, India and Pakistan have got almost the same horoscope, right? They were soon after the division. Of course, a little later, they celebrated one day before, I think, and then we celebrated India ka. We are taking it on the midnight only when we cast Medini horoscope for India. We cast it at the exact time when the independence was declared or freedom was declared. Anyway. So for the entire world, this is Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga. India is included in that. Don't forget about that. And now, what is Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga? Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga is nothing when Rahu is in the second house and Ketu is in the eighth house. Okay, listen to it properly. Rahu is in the second house, Ketu is in the eighth house, and all the planets between them, are hemmed between them. So this yoga is formed. Now, what is the speciality of this yoga? It indicates the huge financial loss and a lot of struggle, conflicts, unrest, a kind of social unrest and terrorism. All those, these are all the negative effects. Now, actually, I was talking about Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga. Now, where it is formed, we need to understand where it is formed. This yoga has started next day of the eclipse, that is on the 5th, okay, in 8th house. Okay, what is 8th house? What is 8th house means Scorpio. I'm talking of Kalapurusha's Kundali, the natural horoscope what we take. So 8th house means it is a malefic house. Actually, it is a what it water element is associated with it. What kind of water? Stagnant water, not the flowing water. Okay. So stagnant water breeds lot of stress and tension. There could be lot of mosquitoes, lot of diseases brewing. You can understand whatever you can associate with stagnant water, what all it can even cause a stink. So you should understand that. Now, eighth house also is called as Mrityusthana. It is one of the malefic houses or Badakasthanas. It's a Mrityusthana. And it's also a kind of house of hidden secrets. Everything that is, buried, like nothing on the surface, you can't make out anything, but everything is secret, like, a lot of secrets are there. And then it indicates a lot of underhand dealings also. And sudden occurrence of events, good or bad, sudden money gain or sudden loss. You know, you might become a millionaire. Suppose you purchase a lottery ticket and you got it, you could become a millionaire. Or if you went for a horse racing and you won millions, or you may become a pauper and next day you have to sell your house also. Those conditions, everything is associated with this eighth house. So sudden wealth gain, sudden wealth loss, and also it is a kind of mysterious thing. You know, like interest in, people will develop interest in occult sciences, and it is always focused towards the dark side of the life. And lot of vindictiveness or, lot of enmity. So these are all the things which are associated with sign Scorpio. That is in the Kalpurusha Kundali, that's in the natural eighth house of the horoscope. Now, who all are placed there now when the Grahana happened? Sun. Now, let us discuss what is Sun. Sun, as I told you earlier also, it is, he is Atma Karaka. Atma means your own existence. See, as long as our Atma is there inside the body, we are there. The minute our Atma moves out, our own relatives, our own people will throw our body out because it is of no use. It will get decomposed. Nobody wants to take that chance. So we are thrown out. So Sun is our existence. Scientifically also, if you think Sun is like, he, because of his warmth and his light, plants are surviving, animals are surviving, humans are surviving. So he is a complete completely responsible for this life. That is why we refer to him as Surya Narayana. Now, who is Narayana? Narayana is the one, like one of the Trimurtis, Narayana or Vishnu. He is the sustainer. He helps to create. I mean, Brahma has created, he maintains, and then Shiva destroys. That is our belief of Trinity. Anyway, I don't want to deviate from the topic. So, we call him as Surya Narayana. So, Sun is very important. Now, this Sun actually is our immunity then. If he is our life, then he has to be our immunity also. And also, what is the quality of Sun? Bright light, right? So, he is the one who dispels the darkness. So, whenever Sun is there, so all the things, dark things and hidden secrets and everything will come to light. Try to understand. I'm going to correlate all these qualities to what I'm talking. Okay. And Sun also means, in Jyotisha, we call him king. Okay, he's a Raja of the planets. Like, so nowadays we don't have Raja, but we have so many Rajas, all the ministers and leaders and everybody. Like, so in our context today, we have to think people of high official rank and those who are associated with the government and political leaders or spiritually anybody leader. Like, these are represented by Sun. Now, Sun is with Ketu. Now, Ketu is the one who is causing this Grahana or causing this eclipse. So, Sun is not in a very happy situation. See, you have a lot of potential. You may be a very good dancer. You know, Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, everything. But your hands and legs are tied and you are put in a situation. Will you be able to dance and show your art? That's what is happening with Sun. So, of course, his vigor cannot be controlled or cannot be contained, but he is in an unhappy situation because of this Grahana association with Ketu, where Kalasarpa Yoga began. His association is not going to be there forever, and this Kalasarpa Yoga dosha also is not going to be there forever. So it is a transitory phase, but you should be aware so that we can protect ourselves. This is, I am giving the information not to scare anybody or not to show that how much, and it's not that. It's just a general, whatever I have understood, I'm telling, so that all of us could be careful and all of us could understand what is happening. This will also help the students of astrology like me who are really studying, and, they may get something out of it. That is it. Now, Ketu denotes trouble to, because of Ketu's association, it denotes trouble to all. Now, when Atma is eclipsed, Atma is suppressed, what happens is, you go into isolation. When you are really not feeling good, when you are really feeling low, would you like to entertain your friends? Would you like to go and laugh outside? No, you are so feeling so forlorn and so lonely. So that kind of a situation the son is in. But after this isolation comes the period of spirituality. You try to connect to God. You try to understand, you know, what is happening, why this is happening. Whatever I am doing, is it worth it? What is the purpose of my life? All these questions may come into the minds of all the people. So that is another thing. So now trouble to son indicates trouble to whatever I discussed now. Let me again tell. There could be political unrest throughout the world, not in India. India is not exceptional. India also will suffer. So there will be life threat to the leaders or, people in power. And accident due to collision, burning and fuel and attack. Because Mars is associated now. Mars is a hot planet and a planet of aggression. Sun is a hot planet. And then, you know, there is Ketu. Ketu also is a hot planet. So all these three things, they are put in a stagnant water and the stagnant water start boiling. So do you expect anything good to come out of it? No. So it will enhance all the negative effects. So all the, like, you know, there is a threat to the life of leaders. This I had mentioned in the video which I posted on the second, also. So what kind of threat? Sometimes, you know, the deaths happen, but a kind of mysterious death. It could be a terrorist attack. You may think that, oh, it was an accident. There could be a collision, but it might have been an intentional collision. So these kind of attacks can happen either through water or in the space or a sky. Okay. So recently we lost our Rawatji. What an important person to India and what all accomplishments he had. So his death also, like, it is so unnatural that a person like him had to die there in that crash. So I don't want to talk more about it, but on the second video I posted, I had mentioned, of course, I didn't know that Rawatji is going to die, but I just told that something like this is going to happen. So we only can show the indicators, you know. So because of this, what happens, you know, then if anything happens like that or any leader's life is in danger or life is lost, then naturally there'll be unrest. But it will come to surface. It's not going to be hidden. Like, you know, it's not clear. Somebody will just, if it is unnatural death, it is going to come out to the surface. That much I can very, very confidently say. Now, sun is there to bring all these things to surface. Now, this is also a time when the cyber crime is going to increase and also drug mafia, lot of drug mafia all over the world and India also. A lot of celebrities will be involved with that. A lot of political people may be involved with that. All of them will be exposed to a great extent. Now, there are two reasons for this exposure, not just Sun alone, who is in not a very good situation. What happens is there is Saturn also. Saturn is in his own house now. Okay. Now, Saturn is called as a great teacher or he's a just, like he's a Nyayadhish, we call him. He's a judge. So if you do right, you're right. If you're doing wrong, you're wrong. So in this particular combination, Saturn also is going to help. But, you know, Jupiter is there. Jupiter is trying to control that. I'll explain in a bit when I talk about it. I'll show you the horoscope. So there may be, activities of terrorism may increase. And then mysterious death of leaders or people in power is a possibility. And then COVID also may increase. Okay, it will be on the increased trend. Not just increase, the cases just not increase. It may be difficult to diagnose also because it is all these combinations are happening in the 8th house. 8th house, what I said, secret. Everything underhand, everything secret. So even a particular disease comes out, na, ultimately, we'll be able to find out a vaccine or whatever, but it is going to take time. But again, because Ketu is involved with research. We will be able to research and find out a remedy, but only when there is an increase, all these remedies will come. Now, we have to understand. Rahu is like a big virus. So, he will only help in spreading the disease. So, Kala Sarpa Yoga is likely to enhance this effect of COVID. Different mutant forms and all it might come, but Ketu will help in finding the vaccine to control the virus. And but this period of right from 5th December 21 to 30th April 22, we need to be extremely, extremely careful. That is what I would say. Now I'll be showing you the horoscope and then I will discuss. Okay, let us now try to understand this Kalasarpa Yoga with the help of charts. Now the chart what you are seeing on this right hand side, this was taken on 4 December 2021 at 1:05 when total solar eclipse was at its maximum. Okay, so what I was talking about the eclipse is, if you could see this 8, where 8 is written, this is Vrishchik Rashi or Scorpion. So here actually Sun and Moon and Mercury and Ketu are posited. Now Moon and Sun are here, so naturally this is a Amavasya day or a new moon day. Ketu is causing Grahana. Ketu is in close conjunction with Sun. Mercury is already present over there. And Mars is actually one foot in, one foot out, that kind of a situation, because Mars was moving towards this house, the 8th house, on 5th September. So analysis of this chart, whatever I have explained, you watch my video on total solar eclipse of 4 December. It's posted on 2nd. Now let me take you through what I mean by Kalasarpa Yoga. As I said, this is Kulika Kalasarpa Yoga. And see, actually I didn't know that I'm going to get this horoscope. Yesterday I was wanting to cast this chart and make the video yesterday itself. So when I took this, what kind of a kundli emerged? This is an India kundli only, because second house, that is Rishabh Lagna. This is like a horoscope of India. Anyway, this is applicable for Kalasarpa Yoga for the entire world. Now, Rahu is posited over here. Exactly opposite is Ketu. So they are always like that, okay? This is the north node, this is the south node. And they are 180 degrees away from each other. In this house, already Mars is here, because he had moved here on 5th September. Sun is still over here. So now three are there. But actually, Mercury has moved out and Saturn and Venus are already here. Moon has moved out here. Then you may ask, how is it Kalasarpa Yoga? It's not Grahan Dosha anymore, because now it is moved out. But Kalasarpa Yoga is between Rahu and Ketu ka axis. All other planets are hemmed if you see. See, if you consider this as the first half of a horoscope, second house, third house, fourth, fifth, sixth, don't go by the numbers. So from here, the yoga is beginning from here to here completely. All the, Uranus and Herschel, I'm not going to, Uranus and Pluto and all, I'm not considering now. So all other planets are hemmed. So this is called as Kalasarpa Yoga. Whatever I described about eighth house in natural kundali comes over here, but this is Lagna, is Vrishabh Lagna, so it is coming over here. So eighth house is Scorpio, so whatever I have discussed, so this is a perfect Kalasarpa Yoga. So the effect is going to remain till, see, Rahu and Ketu always move in a retrograde, in the reverse direction. Now I mentioned that Rahu is going to move. Rahu is not going to move here. Rahu is going to move backwards to Mesha Rashi or Aries, sign of Aries. Then obviously Ketu will come over here, 1 and 7. This will be the axis of Rahu Ketu in April, April 12th, it's going to be there. So now, having said that, what are we supposed to do? Is it everything is going to be bad only, or no, it is not like that. It's a natural phenomenon, it's happening. But you need to understand what we are supposed to do. As far as possible, stick to Sattvika Ahara, Sattvika Acharana. What do I mean by this? Sober food. Keep yourself away from what is forbidden food according to our Samskriti. And if you are a non-vegetarian also, but try to control and stick to vegetarian diet for the next few months. And don't take too much of liquor, or try to avoid it completely. And even whatever you are in, if you are working for a thing, now there will be so much of unrest and so much of mental stress you will create for yourself. Sometimes it may be genuine, sometimes it may be just your own imagination that my boss doesn't like me, or somebody else is pitting against me. See, I'll tell you, your boss could be nasty, your colleagues can play up with you, anybody can play games with you, but what happens is nobody can take away your destiny, you remember. Even if somebody plays politics and sees that you are out of a job or whatever, something else will be waiting for you. You should have that faith in yourself and in the higher power or God. So that is one thing. So even if you are frustrated at a job front and all that, till April end, that is 30th April, it's a general advice. Don't think of changing the job. Of course, you can explore. If you are fed up or if some other opportunity is coming in, you could explore and you could prepare yourself. This is the time to upgrade your skills, upgrade your education. So you could plan yourself to move out, but don't get frustrated and at the fit of anger, don't give your resignation and come back. But if it will be a difficult period. That is one thing. Second thing is, even if there are nasty people around, everywhere there are nasty people. By keeping quiet, you are not going to become small. So let anybody say anything, anybody do anything. You stick to your karma, you do your best and come back. So that is one more advice. Then don't invest too much in the share market and all that. It's likely that the prices might come down and all. Even if you do a lot of research and don't buy anything impulsively, that I would say. And then there will be rains and everything also, unseasonal rains already we are experiencing even before the solar eclipse, soon after the lunar eclipse and all that, lot of rains and everything we torrential rains we experienced. So that might again happen. And as I already told, there may be trouble with commodities also will go up high. And so conserve your money, don't spend unnecessarily. And then now on a spiritual level, what you have to do to ward off these ill effects. The best thing is, Shiv ka Aradhana, like Shivji is the best for everything. Like, you chant Shiva Chalisa, go to Shiva temple, or if you don't know anything more, just chant Om Namah Shivaya. See, when you connect with God, that is more important than, just saying some this thing. Like, it's not that always you have to do an expensive puja and all that. Oh, that reminds me. In the name of Kala Sarpa Yoga, there are astrologers who swindle people out of money. Like, they will say, oh, you have to do this puja and you do this Nagabali, Narayana Bali, and it's very expensive. It will cost. There are people who charge lakh plus rupees for this kind of puja because they will see like who is the person and how much they can afford. They will take assessment of that and then they tell you the charges. Please, please don't do that. Even if you in your own horoscope also, if there is a Kala Sarpa Dosha, do the remedies yourself. Chant continuously Om Namah Shivaya and everything, and Hanuman Chalisa and Hanuman Ji Ka Aradhana, Hanuman Vadvanal Stotra, all these things will definitely give you relief, Shani Chalisa. So you can actually ward off the evils yourself. Connect little bit to God. I'm not saying don't do puja. But don't be gullible to people who are just swindlers in the name of astrologers. Okay, so that is my another request. And I was talking about Jupiter ka control. See, Jupiter is in the 11th house. Okay, now 8th house we had Kala Sarpa Yoga also has occurred and solar eclipse also has occurred. Now, if you take this Jupiter, this will be his 12th house. This will be his 11th house. This is 10th. So 8th house is 10th from 11th, 10th from where Jupiter is deposited. It means actually it's one of the important houses. It is called as Kendra Sthana. So Kendra Bali, he actually is he's trying to control it. It's a Shubha Sthana. Kendra Sthana is Shubha Sthana. See, actually this is 1, 4, then 7 and 10. These are called Kendra Sthanas. In that, this is not very auspicious, but 1, 4 and 10, these are very strong sthanas, Kendra sthanas, and Jupiter controls that. So he's trying to control the situation. See, ultimately it all depends like how we behave, and this is only an advice or a suggestion or like my humble request that to everybody that you need to be on the right track and let others say whatever. Like if you are confident that you're not doing anything wrong, then nothing wrong can go along. Like, if difficulties will come, and I believe that they will only make us emerge stronger. So with this I conclude, and if you have any queries or comments, please write, and I will try to answer them. Thank you very much. God bless. Well, finally, let us understand one more thing about this dosha. Is this dosha going to be continuous and affect us through all the next 4 months? That is from 5th December 21 to 12th April 22. This question might have come up in your mind. No, it's actually no, it's not going to affect. What happens is, if you see the moon's position in this very chart, which I have again pasted over here, if you see the moon is already moved out here. See, when the new moon day was there, there was a eclipse. On the eclipse day, he was here in the 8th house, in the Scorpio. 8th house will be confusing. It's now coming in this. Okay, so it was in Vrishchika Rashi, and then it started moving out, and now moon has reached over here. Now, because actually moon is a very fast moving planet, it moves to the next house in 2.5 days. So when he moves here and here, so when moon moves opposite to sun, that is in Taurus, when the moon is there that day, they are completely opposite to each other in this axis, 180 degrees apart. That day it will be again Purnima, okay, that is full moon day. Then when the moon moves out of this axis, he is free. Then this Kala Sarpa Yoga, the entire yoga what we have discussed, is going to be broken. Now again he has to 2.5 days here, then 2.5 days, so like this completely moon will come up till here, and then again on a new moon day he will enter here. So again moon is there, again Kala Sarpa Yoga is formed. So precisely to tell you, in short, for 15 days we will face the effect of this Kala Sarpa Yoga, and for 15 days it will not be there. It means from the new moon day Amavasya till the next Purnima, that is full moon day, there will be whatever tensions and stress, whatever effect of Kala Sarpa Yoga will be there. But once the moon moves out from here, next 15 days will be a period of relief. This is one point I wanted to say. So there is nothing to worry. So I hope you like this information. If you like this, please share it with the like-minded people who are interested in astrology. Thank you very much.